Hey there, it's Kaylee. In this video, we're going to learn how to convert words to math. There are many phrases and ways to describe how numbers and variables can go together. And it's important that we know how to convert those words to math so we can find solutions. Let's go! Let's start from the very beginning. A mathematical expression is a combination of numbers, like 3, and operators, like plus, and another number, let's say 5. And that's it. How could we describe this expression with words? We could say 5 more than 3. Or 3 increased by 5, or the sum of 3 and 5. And of course, the one that comes to mind first, 3 plus 5. But an expression can also have a variable, like 4 minus x. And we can describe this expression as x less than 4, or 4 decreased by x, or the difference between 4 and x. Now, what if instead of starting with our expression, all we were told was a phrase with words, like x decreased by 12? How would we translate this phrase into a mathematical expression? Well, we have the number 12 and the variable x. What operator is described by the phrase decreased by? Yeah, that's right, the subtraction sign. Now we have all the parts of our expression. We just need to know how to order them. The phrase says x is decreased by 12, so the 12 is doing the work on the x. So x goes first and gets worked on by 12. X minus 12. Let's do this example together. Write the expression for x less than 7. So what do we know? We know that our number is 7. We know that our variable is x. And what's our operator? What operator represents less than? Yeah, that sounds like subtraction to me. So we have our subtraction sign. Now that we have the parts of our expression, we just need to know what order they go in. X less than 7 means that the x is doing the work on 7. So 7 goes first, and we have 7 minus x. This mathematical expression is the same as the phrase x less than 7. Nice job. Now this table is a cheat sheet to help us identify what operator is being described by a phrase. It might be a good idea to pause the video here and copy this table down in your math notes. It's going to be really helpful when we do problems together and you're writing expressions on your own. So let's take a look at what this table means. If we look here, operators, or the operations, are plus, minus, our multiplication, and division signs. And the phrases that represent each of these can be found in the column right next door. So let's look at subtraction sign. The words that mean subtraction are words like minus, the difference, or the difference between, less than, or decreased by. And we write it as x minus 7. And let's really quickly look here at our multiplication and division expressions. So when I say times or product, that means I'm using my multiplication operator. But I don't have to always use this x to represent multiplication. So there's one way to do it, is how we know using our multiplication operator. But you can also write your number and your variable right next to each other, and that also means multiplication. Or you could put parentheses around either your number or your variable. Or you could even do two numbers, like 8 and 6. You can also use a bullet or a dot. 8 with the bullet between the variable or another number also means multiplication. So now let's look at our division here. We know that we can use our division sign, but we can also use a backslash like this. This also means division. And as you probably already know, fractions represent division problems as well. So nice job. Make sure you keep this chart handy. It'll be very helpful when working on your own. Great job. Are you ready to do some practice writing algebraic expressions together? Me too. Join me in the next video so we can do some examples together. I'll see you there. Hey.